Hi, this is Sheshan. Welcome to Aerotech Solutions. I just want to give a lecture on microcontroller block diagram. So many people try to know different microcontrollers in embedded technology. 8051 is a basic microcontroller which is introduced in 1980s. So as a person, if you are aware of one complete microcontroller understanding, it is a common procedure to deal with any microcontroller. So I'll give this simple presentation on this microcontroller. So there are different blocks you may find as a microcontroller block diagram. First one is CPU, and CPU is connected with different blocks with the help of standard buses, RAM and ROM, I/O ports, and timers, counters, interrupts, and serial port. So this is a basic microcontroller block diagram. And again, these blocks have their own individual importance towards system design. There are many manufacturers present in this field like Philips, Atmel, Motorola, Samsung, ST Microelectronics, PIC Microcontrollers, AVR. There are many families which are present in this embedded domain for firmware, and depends on manufacturers. The blocks will be extended towards application point of view, like they are supporting on-chip ADCs, on-chip PWM, on-chip protocol support. So as a basic microcontroller, they given some standards for us. Any manufacturer wants to design their own microcontroller, they have to design with the standard blocks compulsory. So this is the simple view of 8051 microcontroller block diagram. So I'll give in detail with all these individual sections. The first section is CPU, which is central processing unit. And this block is your processor. Every microcontroller which is integrated with processor, with memories, with I/O ports, and with all others some features. For any microcontroller, processor is a very important block, and CPU means it's a processor. And this processor, from processor point of view, you have to understand the three important points. The first one is bit capacity. With respect to 8051 microcontroller, this processor bit capacity is 8 bit. And the second point is architecture. The processor, which is connected with all the different blocks with the help of two standard buses, address bus and data bus. The name of the block or name of the peripheral is defined as address. The address bus, which is used to carry the address between CPU and peripherals, or CPU to memory. And data bus, the name value of the location is defined as data, and data bus, which is used to carry the information between CPU and peripheral or vice versa. If these two buses are in different size and they're giving two different buses for any processor, that processor architecture is hardwired. If they are giving same bus for both address and data, which means they are giving single slot memory addresses, which allows to save RAM, ROM, all the blocks which are present in the same memory. That should be your Van Neumann architecture. In 8051, the CPU, which maintains hardware architecture with two different buses, and the sizes are 16 bit is address bus size and 8 bit is data bus size. And depends on this address bus size, you can calculate how many memory locations you can access with this processor. address bus is 16 bit here, so that you can access 2 power 16 memory locations. So 2 power 16 equivalent is 65536, which is 64k. And data bus size decides the value or information you can store in one location, that is data bus size. As per 8051, data bus size is 8 bit. In one location, it allows to store 0 to 255 max. And every processor supports some list of registers. So these registers, which are used to store data temporarily, 8051 controller's processor also supports some list of registers, which are A, B, R0 to R7. A and B are your SFRs, and R0 to R7 is your general purpose registers, and which also supports some 16-bit registers, DPTR, data pointer, and PC, which is program counter. Even there is another list of SFRs, but remember, every processor supports some list of registers. And so these are the three important points: bit capacity, architecture, and registers. This is the common information you should find out from any processor. Maybe the processor is inbuilt of controller, or processor is outside of controller. Next block, which is random access memory. So this memory, which allows to store data temporarily, for 8051 microcontroller, there is a 128 bytes of data RAM, so that the addresses are 0 to 127 in decimal representation. If you are converting the same 00 to 127 in hexa format, you'll get 00H to 7FH. And this memory allows both read operations and as well as write operations. This RAM memory is called as data memory in microcontrollers. So this is a simple representation of memory from beginning address 00H and the last address is 7FH. So each location allows 1 byte value. The next block, which is ROM, read-only memory. This memory allows to use it to store data permanently. From 8051, ROM memory is 4 kilobytes. So that the addresses are 0 to 4095. If you are converting this value into hexa format, you may get 000H to 0FFFH. And this is a read-only memory. It won't allow any write operations through instruction. Another name of this memory is code memory or program memory in microcontroller. Maybe address may be 16 bit here. It is more than 8 bit. But the information or value you can store in one location is max 1 byte. This is a simple representation of ROM memory from 8051. Usually the I/O ports, which are used to connect so many peripherals. From 8051, there are 4 I/O ports. Each port contains 8 pins, so that 32 pins provided from 8051 family. And port names are port 0, which have the pins from 0.0 to 0.7. And the next port is port 1. It has the pins from P1.0 to P1.7. Port 2, same, 2.0 to 2.7. And port 3 also have the same pins, 3.0 to 3.7. Generally, these I/O ports are used to connect peripherals like sensors, displays, motors. So I'll show you some example devices, like most cases LCDs, 7 segments, servo motor, traffic indicators, sensors, motors, keypads, audio, and electrical loads. So any microcontroller uses these I/O ports to connect external devices. So from 8051, we have 32 pins you can use for your applications. And timers, counters. Generally, timers are used to generate accurate time delays, depends on application requirement. 8051 supports two 16-bit timers, the same are used as counters also. These two 16-bit timers are timer 0, which has T1, T0 and T1. So even you can use this timers or slash counters block for applications where you are expecting accurate time delays in between operations. And counters are used to count external objects or any counter-based product or you're looking to design, you can use this counters block from 8051. Now interrupts. Generally interrupt you will feel as a disturbance, but they're adding as a feature for your microcontrollers. Still, interrupt, which is considered as the feature for your controllers, because if you want to do your work with electronic system, this interrupts is an important block which helps to hold any execution and it allows to execute any high priority task from your application. So this high priority task, which is called as interrupt service routine in programming. So this high priority task, which is allowed to execute if we are providing interrupt signal to the device. If you are not giving interrupt signal, which is keep on executing main program. From 8051, there are 6 interrupt resources, including reset. But reset not used for programming. But still, reset is considered as an interrupt because it is disturbing main program execution. From 8051, there are 3 hardware interrupts, which are reset, INT0 and INT1. And even it is giving software interrupts, timer 0, timer 1 and serial interrupt. So hardware interrupts expects external pulses from any one of the resource, maybe switch, button or sensors as your optional. And software interrupts, which are occurred based on the flags, depends on timer's uses, depends on serial communication operations. So we'll see more in detail in applications about this interrupts from 8051. But the behavior of interrupt is very simple. It allows to stop the main program and it is going to execute interrupt service routine. And it comes back from interrupt service routine to main program and it executes your main program as usual. The last feature is serial port. Generally, there are I/O ports used to connect peripherals already. And the serial port, which allows to communicate with external devices through protocol. Whereas across serial port, even you are connecting physically the pins, which are not allowed to share the data with the external devices. Until unless you are not doing proper programming and you are not implementing protocol. 8051 supports one basic protocol, which is UART, Universal Asynchronous Receiver or Transmitter. And the identification of device, which protocol it follows, depends on the physical pins from any microcontroller. There is the device which is supporting UART protocol, you may get RXD and TXD pins from the device. For other protocols, you may get SDA, SCL for I2C and MISO, MOSI for SPI, D plus and D minus for USB. So like this, every individual protocol has its own physical pins from controllers. And this serial port, which is used to communicate with the modems like Bluetooth, RFID readers, GPS, GSM, Zigbee. There are many modules which are in market, so which are communicating with the microcontrollers through serial port protocol, which is UART. So this is the simple representation of all the blocks from 8051. For more videos, just follow our channel, which is Aerotech Solutions. Please like, share and comment. If you are expecting training from us, just reach us this address. We are located in Housing Board Metro Station, near to very near to Housing Board Metro Station and bus stop in Bhagyanagar Colony, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. And reach us with this contact number 9676327118. Any queries, please mail us. Thanks for watching.